Welcome to this video. Are you interested in why your vehicle diagnosis displays P0620? How is the error code interpreted by the vehicle? What does P0620 mean, or how to correct this fault? Today we will find answers to these questions together. Let's do this. First, let's look at the history of diagnostic fault code composition according to the OBD2 protocol, which is unified for all automakers since 2000. We divide the electric system of automobile into the four basic units: powertrain, body, chassis, network. This distribution is defined in the first character code. If the second character is expressed as zero, it is a standardized error. In the case of numbers 1, 2, 3, it is a more prestigious expression of the car-specific error. The third character specifies a subset of errors. The distribution shown is valid only for the standardized DTC code. Only the last two characters define the specific fault of the group. Let's not forget that such a division is valid only if the other character code is expressed by the number 0. Our website airbagreset.sk produces useful videos for you. You do not have to go through the OBD2 protocol anymore to know how to troubleshoot any car breakdown. You will find all the diagnostic codes that can be diagnosed in Lincoln vehicles, also many other useful things. The following demonstration will help you look into the world of software for car control units. You unbelievably can move the video a bit further. The error code is split into two bytes consisting of 16 bits. One bit is the basic unit that each computer works with. The bit has two logical states: 0, low level, 1, high level. By combining the first two bits, the basic character of the error code is expressed. The next two bits again determine the second character. The last bit styles of the first byte define the third character of the code. The second byte is composed of a combination of 8 bits. The first 4 bits determine the fourth character of the code, and the combination of the last 4 bits defines the fifth character. A single byte conceals 256 possible combinations. We now know in what way the diagnostic tool translates the received information into a more comprehensible format. The number itself does not make sense to us if we cannot assign information about it to what it actually expresses. So, what does the diagnostic trouble code P0620 interpret specifically for Lincoln car manufacturers? The basic definition is: front passenger anchor pretensioner circuit short to ground. And now this is a short description of this DTC code. The location of the retractor tensioner passenger sill end pretensioner is within the plastic trim of the B pillar. The anchor buckle tensioner is an internal part of the seat belt retractor. When powered, the occupant restraint controller AUX sends a test current to the squibs to verify the integrity of the squib and wiring. These circuits are maintained in a floating configuration at the AUX, connected to neither power nor ground as protection against inadvertent deployment. Use of the supplemental restraint system SRS load tool in the tests below substitutes a suspect squib with a known good component. The SRS load tool provides a test point as well as a method for opening the shorting bar connections within the AUX harness connector. The retractor tensioners cannot be repaired, and if ineffective or damaged, the entire retractor tensioner unit is to be replaced. Following any front airbag deployment, the retractor tensioners will also be replaced. A growling or grinding sound while attempting to operate the seat belt retractor is a sure sign the retractor tensioner has been deployed and needs to be replaced. This diagnostic error occurs most often in these cases: R506 passenger seat belt retractor line 1 circuit shorted to ground, R504 passenger seat belt retractor line 2 circuit shorted to ground, passenger seat belt tensioner passenger sill end pretensioner retractor restraint controller AUX. The Airbag Reset website aims to provide information in 52 languages. Thank you for your attention and stay tuned for the next video.